Hey, Tiago, AI will kill astrophotography.
That's awesome.
Have an artificial intelligence that creates.
So much easier.
Answer in just one sentence. Will AI kill astrophotography?
No, AI will not kill astrophotography, but it may change the way it is practiced and improve the quality of the images. Alexa, will artificial intelligence kill astrophotography?
Artificial intelligence is not likely to end astrophotography. In fact, artificial intelligence can be a great tool for astrophotographers to improve their images.
I don't know. It looks like when we are in the doctor and we ask, "Doctor, will it hurt?" Well, just a bit. And if we ask to artificial intelligence how it see us in the future and tell it to draw it, this is the result. I mean, super weird. Don't you agree? And it gets even more weird if you ask how it sees an astrophotographer in the future. Oof, it's super creepy. Look at the expressions, everything. And if I ask it to draw Messier 51, the Whirlpool Galaxy, it's like a unicorn. However, this is just the creative part of AI, which is improving and already can do text to videos. However, an important part of AI has been useful even to NASA, mainly through machine learning, an important component of AI, to process millions of pictures, allowing NASA to make the analogy with other planets, to find similarities and identify their structure. But they are also using AI to track the evolution, for instance, of volcanoes like the one that exists in Tenerife, Canary Islands, or the Toshka Lakes in Egypt, to track the transformation on Earth. So AI can be a bit abstract, but also can be a great tool for humanity. However, AI can be also very dangerous. It has a dark side. Well, in fact, two. One caused by us, humans, if it falls in the wrong hands and get out of control. And the recent 6 months moratorium, which addressed that, signed by very important people, whom also state the second danger, which is basically what we all fear, that AI take control of the humanity and get rid of us after realize that we are inferior beings. That mess it all, kind of true, and get rid of the humans forever. And no one wants that, at least no one human. But in astrophotography, we have another minor danger. And the danger is to overprocess using AI the astrophotos, leading us to more unicorns, further apart from the real capture that the astronomer did. And the problem is that I already saw some of those unicorns online receiving loads of likes in social networks, and they didn't even use AI. I wonder when they start using AI to do that.
We have been enhancing the images of the nature, their colors, their shapes, to be better in the pictures. But there's a difference in the objects in the sky, because they are so faint and so distant that we gotta trust in the images.
And that's why we trust NASA or ESA images. We know that they work with different techniques to capture detailed and very important information of the sky from a scientific approach. And even the images that James Webb Space Telescope took and were provided to us to contemplate didn't have all those colors. That's because James Webb works on the wavelength of the infrared. However, NASA matched the different infrared waves with the colors we humans know to allow our brains to better process and contemplate those beautiful images in a more natural way. And no, NASA didn't use AI, as far as we know, over those captures. So we have two different approaches to the use of the AI in astrophotography. One, the scientific approach, the NASA approach, which only uses AI to collect data and process it, not adding artifacts to any image. And also we have the aesthetical approach, which is the one that pleases our eyes. Everybody likes to watch a good picture. But there's where the danger starts in astrophotography. Ask yourself, why do you do astrophotography? But ask deeply inside of you, be honest with yourself, and check if you do astrophotography to post pictures and receive many likes and satisfy your ego, boosting dopamine to your brain, or if you do astrophotography as a kind of art, you're an artist and you enjoy the process of enhancing all the details of your picture to reach at the end a good result, which is your result, your product with your own perspective. Even that the colors were different or some details are more enhanced than others, the reason why you do that, it's very important. However, whether you do it for the likes or whether you do it from an artist's point of view, both have an option to use AI to manipulate the images. I'm not talking about deconvolution, star sharpening, all those tools that astrophotographers use to enhance colors and details. I'm talking about someone artificially using its intelligence to change your image, reaching a result that is further apart from the reality, from the first image you captured with your telescope. And those situations can lead to the usual unicorns. Again, one obsessive with the likes, use artificial intelligence because nobody knows, and post an unicorn that everybody like. And another one, as an artist, passing the threshold he or she usually doesn't pass, but wanting to extend the artist's point of view, and remember, art means freedom, to a more open-minded level, using AI to help in that goal. However, I have a problem. I don't consider myself an astrophotographer. I like to do live stacking, or EAA, electronically assisted astronomy, call it whatever you want, but I'm just a simple guy that points a telescope to the sky and with the help of the camera watch much better the objects in my monitor as they are in reality. But yes, sometimes I do a quick astrophotography, specifically using Topaz Denoise, which uses AI, but at the moment, to clean the noise from my pictures, it's the most convenient tool I have access to. By the way, you have the links of all my gear and the software I use at the description below. And why do I post my images? Honestly, for one simple reason, to promote my YouTube channel. Through my pictures, people know my channel, therefore I can help more people to learn what I do with the Dobsonians, which is watching the sky in real time. Of course, to do that, I also have the help of my sponsor, AstroArt Finland, your astronomical partner.
And that's what I really love to do, is to watch the sky in real time, doing live stacking, as I do during my live streams. I will ask someone that knows about astrophotography, what does he think about this? And I will ask him if he thinks that artificial intelligence is killing astrophotography. Besides, I love to place here in my observatory the Dobsonians pointing to the sky, do the star hopping, learning the sky, enjoying everything in a natural way. I don't want any machine to answer a question like, show me the object X, and she just place it on the screen and that's it. I don't want that. I want to do it in a natural and keep it simple style.
Hey, Tiago from Dobsonian Power. This is Nico from Nebula Photos. And I don't think that AI will kill astrophotography. You know, we can have an artificial intelligence that creates a picture that looks just like astrophotography. But to me, astrophotography is still about a person getting out there with a telescope and taking a picture of something out in space. So it's not going to replace that aspect of it. I can't really imagine that people will be as satisfied by just having an artificial intelligence take the pictures for them or create the pictures for them. For me, it's still about getting out there and doing it. So there's also AI tools in astrophotography processing, but to me, those are just tools. They're about enhancing the art or the photography in some way. They're not about replacing it or killing it.
This was Nico Carver from Nebula Photos YouTube channel and website, which I strongly recommend. Not only because it's a great astrophotographer from deeply inside, but also superior as a person, as he demonstrated giving the end to a small channel like mine. Thank you very much, Nico. But did you pay attention to this part?
That I can't really imagine that people will be as satisfied by just having an artificial intelligence take the pictures for them or create the pictures for them.
So Nico don't believe that somebody will, in the future, delegate it all to AI to create a picture replacing the human being that want a final picture. But I want you to think in something that I often see all over the place. When you capture raw files from an object and then ask other people to process those images and then get a final result, who is the artist there? And if instead of asking to your friend, a human, you ask to artificial intelligence to do exactly the same thing, who is the creator? Let's listen another point of view.
Hey Google, connect to Tokyo.
So AI and astrophotography, well, it so happens that I'm lazy, and honestly, AI is probably the tool that has the most potential of helping me be lazy. I mean, viewers of my channel know I love things like Blur Exterminator, Star Exterminator, or Noise Exterminator. They're all AI powered and they make the processing of images so much easier. And I think processing is one of the hardest aspects of our hobby. And my dream is actually to have like an AI tool that could pre-process my image. And by pre-process, I mean like give you a range of final images based on your stack and with the steps taken for each. And it's not going to be perfect, but it's going to give you an idea of, you know, what is achievable with your image. And then you can choose whether or not to take that path or which path to take or to take inspiration from that. Sean from Visible Dark has shown a very interesting use of ChatGPT, where he asked ChatGPT to create pixel mass formula, and ChatGPT was able to, and that's awesome. And so I'm looking forward to more automation as long as AI doesn't like, you know, basically replace our pictures with stuff off of the internet, right? There was this weird Samsung moon picture thing recently. I don't know if that was true or not, but I don't want to see like all of our pictures becoming Hubble pictures because the AI decided it was easier than processing our pictures to just download something from the internet. That wouldn't surprise me. But anyway, overall, I'm looking forward to seeing what's coming with AI in astrophotography.
Also a great person, Cuiv the Lazy Geek with YouTube channel and astrophotographer. Thanks, Cuiv. At the end, it's up to us humans as creators and as artists to use the tools like artificial intelligence in a proper way. But don't cut your wings. The wings are to fly, and being an artist means freedom. So release yourself, do what you have to do, ask for help to AI if needed, and just write next to the picture the software you used. That way everybody knows and everything is fine. And someone that doesn't know how to work with AI very soon will do nothing in their jobs. It is installed everywhere and even in your phone probably. If you have one of the last Samsung models, you may be interested to click on this video over here to know how Samsung is using AI to artificially deliver you better moon pictures.